I, for today's teardown, the contents of not one but two olive green bags. So they were on a classified website for available for 50 euros. And the seller did say if not sold, they will go to the recycling. I could not let it go and I purchased them. What do we have here? It is a French military equipment. The CFTM1 radio remote control system. So it is some kind of field telephone that will allow to control locally and remotely military radios. And I will be able to test them with my EM25. I have a user manual here in French describing the system. So you can control the radio from each of the two sets, and you can also use the sets as a field telephone for or interphone. It comes in these things. It uses the PS28 or AA47 battery block. It is a alkaline, I believe, battery, not available anymore. I did check on eBay and really you do not find them. They are not rechargeable batteries. I was not provided them and I was not able to locate one in working condition. They are 15 volts battery. Here is the how you could connect it. So you have your military radio to the first box, just a cable between the two sets, and it is all the information you need. So how does it look like? First, the master unit. We have it here. So a very sturdy olive green box with your regular U77 connectors. They are made both by Elno, which is a French company, and actually it is still around, and they are still making military communications equipment mostly. Apparently we have a date code of 1988 here. So this main control box is the BC451B. Serial number here for you, French Army of course. So you have your push contacts for field telephone wire. You have your two plugs for the radio, your control buttons, your volume buttons, and one call button that will make a tone on the remote set. Nothing else on this box except one air briefing screw here. Here apparently some grounding screw. Weird sticker here with weird writing, because it seems to have seven here and a one, but here the one seems to be upside down. Really, really strange. And apparently you can secure them to something. And this access panel here with two quick release screws, well, fasteners, is the location for your battery block. Luckily enough, the pinout is written, so it will allow me to connect something and test them. Actually, I did prepare a piece of wire like this. So of course in a real use the two sets will not be connected by so short wire, but it will allow me to test them It is mostly regular banana plug, so I did use a scrap banana sockets. Okay, not necessary to reinstall the cover for now. So here is the first set. What else do we have in the bag? We have the interconnect wire for the radio. Regular, yes. U77 slash U connector. They were made by a number of companies. This one is made by Bernier. It is a name I did never see before on a connector. I do not know this company. Seems very French. Overplug is the same brand. And the cable itself. So everything is French so far in this set. Saint-Chamond, France. Cable KU66A. And apparently the code of 87 here. Cable number here with the proper NATO number. Okay. So it will allow me to connect it to my EM25. What do we have else? And it is very good because I did not have them, and now I have two of them. The regular handset. Here they are called the CB37, but you find them in the other numbers. Still NATO stock number and still made by Elno Company in Argenteuil, France. Okay, so they are a little bit rough, but you have what you have. I will not complain. I did not have any of them, so it is still good. Of course, same connector. Okay, first bag is empty. Inside we have equipment list. And really thick and sturdy material here, really strong, as you can expect. Okay, the second unit. So you have the same handset in a maybe a little bit better condition, not sure. So one thing, there is apparently an ambient sound blocking feature on this microphone. You can turn this thing, and you have holes in the middle here that will block noise around or not. Your push-to-talk button, of course. And they are not exactly the same cable, at least. This one is Cabletel 1988. This one has no brand, and it is called KQ66. Okay, so this second unit, same factor, same size, but less connections and controls, as it is the remote unit. So this time called V, not the correct remote, by the way. Called the TL64A, bigger serial number. Okay, and exactly the same setup with your access panel here for the same battery, like such. So let me hook up some wires and we will test them, or try to at least. Okay, we are all set up according to the manual. The maximum distance between two sets is 3.2 km. So you can expect some kind of high voltage on these terminals here to go through 3 km of wire. Not sure. So it is on, the radio is on. I am set here to radio A. I am connected onto radio A. And surely enough, you can hear the radio noise in the handset, both of them. Now if I go to interphone, okay. Actually, in this configuration, I was not expecting to still hear the radio noise, but it is what it is. Then we have the call button that will make a tone in the remote handset. This handset is the one connected to the bottom set. So it is to call the remote operator. Works in both directions. You have a telegraph mode here because you can apparently hook here a telegraph key or something, which I do not have. Okay, and what else? Nice night glowing paint on here, but no radio, I did test already. And if I press here and I talk in here, you should hear me in this excuse me, I have only one hit, so it is not very easy. Hello hi, Putin is sending us scuds. Hi. Okay, it is working. You have more controls here, not sure what they do. Yes, you can select which radio will be used to transmit, but it is a little bit weird. This button will not remain in place. It is a self-return button, but why? You should not want it to be still selected. I am not sure. Okay, so pretty straightforward units, as you can see. I'm not sure you are supposed to call both at the same time. Okay, one thing I can do is to hook up a multimeter to these wires while I call and see if we have any high voltage around. For my safety, I will first turn it off. Okay, interesting. So let's hook the multimeter. We should not have any DC. Could be only AC, I believe. So first, there's nothing in DC. Little bit of offset maybe. If I go to AC, only 1.5 volts. Interesting. I was expecting a lot more, actually. Here we can hear the radio. If I modify the frequency on the radio, this is my 725. Okay. Okay, I was expecting a lot more actually. Maybe there is something I am missing, not sure. So, here we are for the test of the features. Now, time for the teardown. So I am mostly curious to see the brand of parts we'll have in this, because so far everything is typically French. Screws are regular metric Allen screws, 3 mm. buttons are copied from the US military radio buttons, like on PRC-9 and things like this. Same model, but probably with a metric screw in the middle. I will open the two sets in parallel, so it will be easier to compare what we have in each one. Let me just undo the screws in the second one. It will be pretty quick. Like such. Okay. So, are you ready? First unit, master unit. There is obviously some seal. It is quite sticky. Okay, so we have first the bottom compartment with mostly battery box. Some quick disconnects here are provided with a nice color code. Apparently, the battery is backed by electrolytic capacitor that is screwed in the base here. Let's check which brand it is. Why not? Screwdriver is too big, by the way. So two screws that will allow to remove it, and it is Prosec brand, 2002 microfarads, apparently French manufacture. Okay, dead code on it. It is not every day you see a dead code on a electrolytic capacitor. Well, sometimes, but not always. Okay, so typically French manufacture for this part. I put this on the side, I will put it back together later. The brand LNO is repeated here inside, and we have C1 for the capacitor. We have again the pinout of the battery. Okay. And about the contents of this unit, one big circuit board on the front panel, golden connections. Here it is not every day you see these connectors in gold, and one Dover circuit board by Suryo, like such. So I am curious to see if the circuit board in the second unit will be the same. I do a little bit of marking because I will take them apart, so I want to be able to reassemble the correct things together. Okay, so first unit. Let's open quickly the second one. Same deal. We have a seal. Oops. Okay. Apparently, very similar setup for the base unit at least. Not the same brand of capacitor, but same thing. I guess you could exchange them with no problem. Same manufacturer code here, everything. Okay. And we have apparently a much more simple circuit board, as you can expect. But the Dover circuit board seems we have the same thing. Yes, except for some parts that are a little bit different. But it is the same board. Interesting. So I will continue to take the thing apart. So about this board, very serious Sorio connector, and apparently you are just to squeeze out the other way and pull, okay? So what do we have? 2N2222 transistors, no brand on them. Motorola 2N2905, so very regular parts here. Sphernis trim pot. These capacitors are typically French air grade capacitors. Sorio, so it is French also. So apart for the Motorola transistors, I believe we have mostly French components on here. You can see this board has its own serial number. No bulge on the back. Very clean. Some conformal coating, not too thick. Okay. The second one is the same. Also, serial number. Different capacitors. Well, different color of wrap around the capacitor because it is written Novea. And Novea here also. Okay, only enough. I see a 77 dead cord on this tantalum capacitor. 77 here also. It is weird because I was expecting it to be 88, but do we have any date on this thing? Ah, 76. So probably the cables and handsets are a little bit more modern and are from the 80s. Interesting, but it is a 70s era. Okay, here the transistors are not the same brand. I guess this logo is a French company, even if I cannot remember which name it is for the company. Okay, now that this boards are undone, obviously I have to undo some screws to see what we have under here. So let me do it. If I find somewhere to put the screws. Should be pretty quick. Turn this is too big again. So this is the remote unit, much more simple. You can see between the two things we have the same layout of the screws because the case is mostly the same thing. It is what you can expect and apparently I believe this board will just pull out because I see here what seems to be a large connector. Yes. Okay. So what do we have here? We have mostly three transformers. So probably to a line transformer and then transformer for the handset, level conversion, something like this. A Sorio connector with this time. Wow, look at these gold pins. Really, really nice. Deep gold. Okay, the transformers are interesting. Yes, they are in fact regular ones, but they are clamped to the board with this plastic or bakelite, something, clamps. Each one is secured by four screws, spare no expense. And here actually, two of the screws are used for the circuit board rail. Okay. Really, really nice. Still, same round, serial number. Some arrow with dots here. Maybe it is for the manufacturing process. Not sure if it is a wave soldered or something. Okay, so no special stuff here, except maybe this quite long, probably wet tantalum capacitor with precise brand. Okay, about what we have in the front panel, the cable terminals with capacitors to ground apparently. And one resistor here, one more terminal here not used. Nice wire loom with handmade wire lacing. What else? Some standoff here with terminals to connect more wires. Clamp here to the front panel. The back of your plugs, of course. The body of the volume control, which is branded Sphernice. Again, and this rotary selector, which has nice also gold contacts branded. So Jean Reno doll. So it is a city in France, Doll, and Jean Reno seems obviously very French. And Suyin, so this sounds Asian. So is it a model number, or is it maybe made under license from another company? I will research with two names. Okay, again, very nice golden contacts here. So you can see how modular the construction here, really, really good. The cables are really not moving, except maybe a little bit here. But everywhere else, they are really well secured. And very, very clean. Okay, now we undo the second board. So same layout of the screws. And apparently the same connector here to release the board. So it is really nicely made. It is why I love taking apart military stuff, by the way. And aircraft stuff. So obviously a lot more parts on this board. Okay, first we have two shielded relays by STPI Paris with a schematic here, date code or something here, 88, which is interesting, and a super nice logo here that should look like almost a Soviet company logo, looks like a UFO or something like this. Spaceship, really, really interesting. Of course, there are shielded relays with terminals to wire, so they did screw them to the board, and then use little jumper wires like this. Each one making a nice little loop. Apart from this, we have the same kind of transformers, again three of them. Same capacitor here at the same location, but two extra transformers here. Maybe for connection to the two remote radios or something. And this time a whole bunch of transistors. Mostly 2N2222. Okay. Again by Motorola this time. So really, really a nice board, say number as always. Okay, in the front panel, if I compare both of them, you can see quite similar for this area. Same wire loom. Here they did not use this part here. Instead, there is a grounding point on the capacitor, which is quite seriously glued to the front panel. Okay. Push buttons. Same potentiometer here, except the location. Okay. And everything nicely labeled. Okay. So here we are for these things. So really, really nice equipment. Beautiful stuff. That will require some time to pack a bat together, by the way. So it does align by itself, really. No reason to complain here. You just put it like this, and here you are. So really, really nicely made. So just for some screws to put back in place, and it will be wrapped. I will of course keep them in my collection. So thanks for watching, bye bye.